Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Let us pray. Assist us mercifully with your help, O Lord, our God, of our salvation. When they were approaching Jerusalem and Bethany and the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say, 'The Lord needs it,' and will send it back immediately." They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming of the kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went to the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. The Gospel of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Let us go forth in peace. The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to praise you, Almighty God, for the acts of love by which you have redeemed us through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. On this day, he entered the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph and was proclaimed as the King of Kings by those who spread their garments and branches of palm along the way. Let these branches be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life, who lives and reigns with glory with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. in your tender love for the human race, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our nature, and to suffer death upon the cross, giving us the example of his great humility. Mercifully grant that we may walk in the way of his suffering, and also share in his resurrection, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Say together the psalm, verses 9 through 16. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eyes are consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly. For my life is wasted with grief, and my ears with sighing. My strength falls because of affliction. Same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in
humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend in heaven and on earth and under the sea, or under the earth. And even and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of the Father, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
It is both tradition and custom in the church on Palm Sunday to read of Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem, but also to read the passion of his crucifixion. And we will do that this morning in a moment. What I would like to do is, normally we have different people read things. The only responses I would ask is when the questions from Pilate are posed, I would like you to respond as the crowd would have crucified him. And also, take this time. We are coming at the end of Lent, and also we are at a time where the pandemic seems to be getting a little bit better, and things are approaching a new normal. Think about the things that you would want to do differently or be different. And take the time after we read the Passion and Christ's sacrifice for us to think what you would like to do as we both leave Lent and as we leave the pandemic behind us, hopefully. And take that time. I will give you a moment of silence after the reading of the Passion to do just that. So breathe slowly and listen for God's word to you. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and the scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered him, "You say so." Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you." But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests had stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them. Barabbas spoke to them again, "Then, what do you wish me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?" They shouted back,
"Crucify him."
Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed and spat on him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put on his own clothes on him, Then they led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, and he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "Aha! You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also taunted him. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he is calling for Elijah." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, and put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion, who stood facing him, saw in this way that he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was God's son." There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, and Mary, the mother of James, the younger, and of Joseph and Salome. These used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who had come up with him from Jerusalem. When evening had come, and since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate wondered if he was already dead, and summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph brought a linen cloth, taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth, and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn from the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of Joseph saw where the body was. Please reflect in silence, and I will break the silence with hymn 168. Please listen as the choir sings. Thank you. Let us proclaim our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God for God, light for light, true God for true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. We believe in the Holy Spirit, we acknowledge our baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. The prayers of the people will be according to Form 3 this morning. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they be faithful ministers of the Lord and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
That light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come share in your country kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace. As we close the service, we had originally planned to do communion outside. Since there's such a small number of you, I just ask you to come up one group at a time, one household at a time, and I will serve communion, and then we'll go back to the seats, and I'll dismiss you then. Okay? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray in the words our Savior Christ has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them.
in the remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts with thanksgiving. Body of Christ, the bread of life. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. 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 The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
There's supposed to be a basket there.